persisting for a variety of factors, including supply chain disruption and the conflict in Ukraine. Despite aggressive action by the Fed, the cost of gas, oil and food continue to rise. And joining us now is CBS News Chief Foreign Affairs Correspondent and Face the Nation moderator Margaret Brennan. Margaret, the Russian military went on the offense this week with strikes in Kyiv and other major cities. What are you hearing from your contacts?
Well, this was a barrage of major cities, and we heard today from Vladimir Putin, the president of Russia, say that he no longer sees the need to continue this kind of action. And he said that he will, in the next 2 weeks, wind down the conscription, that mobilization of more soldiers to send to the front. It's hard to know what to believe here. That's why we're going to speak to Ukraine's ambassador to the United States, Oksana Markarova, about that. We know that President Zelensky has been really pressuring the United States to deliver more quickly those surface-to-air missile defense systems that the United States has promised but not yet delivered, and they're still about a month out. So there is an effort on the part of the allies in the West to try to prepare the Ukrainians for what could be a very difficult winter.
Well, let's take that a step further. When you're speaking with Ukraine's ambassador to the U.S., are you hoping to learn more about that government's strategy, especially after Russia attacked their critical infrastructure, including power, as you mentioned, heading into these winter months?
We want to talk to her about a number of things on that front, including these reports that the Pentagon has now confirmed have been conversations with a private company called SpaceX. You may know it. Elon Musk is the founder of it, that provided these Starlink uplink to the internet methods and communications gear that has helped Ukrainian soldiers. And now there's this back and forth, this issue over who's going to pay the bill, the private company or Western allies or the United States. So we are getting to this point where there are some questions about the amount of money that's being poured into the conflict, the duration of it, and some of the mechanics that could really be consequential in these coming months when battlefields get muddier, when even though Russian troops are on the move out of areas in the east in certain spots, it's not clear that there's an end to the war. Certainly, Vladimir Putin didn't give any indication that he's ready to stop fighting when he made remarks today.
Margaret Brennan, thank you. Quick programming note, you can watch Face the Nation right here on CBS News. It streams 12 p.m. and 4 p.m. Eastern every Sunday.